his music is saying "fuck you" to the audience, but in a really beautiful way. It's like, "fuck you, I love you. Now let me play you some beautiful music." You know, so there's this feeling like they're gonna do whatever they want and assert their own will and not worry about how it's being understood or whatever. Yet the wonderful thing about that is that it speaks to people.
Hello, everybody. Oh god, I realize my OBS is broken. That's not good. Is it gonna OBS? Oh, I heard myself there for a second. Hello? Big Q. Hello?
Sorry. They left.
Are you alright?
That was
pretty.
Yeah, no.
That was pretty
interesting, huh?
Yeah, I didn't expect. They seemed to be a lot more, you know, like agitated than I thought. I didn't think this was gonna be too much of a big deal.
But you know that it's what happens when people start, you know. When people start competing against you, here's the thing, and here's the saying I've always heard, is people will root for you until you're doing better than them.
Really?
Right? When you start doing better than them, that's when everyone turns on you. They start getting jealous, all that thing. You know, so I think there's a situation where maybe, I don't know, Wilbur was rooting for us until we started doing better than him.
I mean, we haven't really we haven't got many burgers yet, but we're not quite doing better yet, but we got to work on that.
Tubbo, you shouldn't even worry about that. I have so much trust in you for you to run this place. You know what? This place has had the possibility of getting many employees, But I thought you were the best. I really did. I think, and you were telling me this whole thing about how you needed to find purpose, you needed to do something.
Yeah.
And you know, this I feel like this is a good place to start.
Yeah, sure. I just want to say thank you so much for letting me work here, man. I mean, I feel like I haven't had much to do like ever until I finally have this job. Like, it's nice to finally have a purpose, like something to do, a reason to do stuff.
Yeah, and Tubbo, listen, it doesn't have to end here, you know? Like, a lot of things are happening with the country, you know, there's a lot of people in here.
Yeah, yeah.
Things can move forward in a really, really good way. And Tubbo, I trust you. I mean, we were comrades and you know, Lemanberg and all that. So this is great. This is really good.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that. Especially after like that little blip we had.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Like, yeah. I don't want to like ruin the moment, but there is something we.
Yeah, should we maybe like head over there?
Come with me. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Listen, I'm putting a lot of trust in you.
Yeah, I really appreciate that as well. Like,
this is really
exciting.
I do want to talk about that one thing. And we never really discussed it.
Yeah, we kind of just like, you know, left it like, oh, this I didn't want to jeopardize my chances of getting the job, you know.
No, and at the end of the day, it's not even about the job, Tubbo. I think not jeopardizing our friendship and the history we had together.
Yeah.
I think that's the most important part to me, because you know what? Jobs come and go. You're meant for so many bigger things. This is where we're starting, Tubbo, but you know.
First this, tomorrow the world, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. What? I'm just gonna be straight up with you.
Why the fuck is there a duck on it?
What's this, Tubbo?
I'm gonna be honest. That is not me. I didn't do that one.
Put that up there.
I did.
Okay, that's fine. But yeah, the cookie say, okay. Outpost.
Yeah, yeah. As a whole, I mean,
we had a whole discussion. You and me were fighting.
Yeah, I mean, it got like really heated. Yeah,
what was this for? Tubbo?
I don't know. Like, it was mainly just to sell cookies, if I'm honest. I wasn't myself
Tubbo,
that day.
Tubbo.
Yeah?
What was it actually for?
Oh, I just kind of wanted to keep an eye, if you know what I mean. I just wanted to see what everyone was up to. It wasn't ever like a sign of aggression or anything. It was just me being nosy. I just wasn't acting like myself. I'm sorry.
It just felt super out of nowhere for you to come and build this whole entire
complex. Yeah.
Country. Yes. So you know what? It still feels a little weird to you. It's like a needle is poking me. Like, I have no problems with you, but there's something there that, you know, keeps me uneasy.
Yeah, I 100% understand.
Tubbo,
that.
I don't think this is a really nice structure. This is
I appreciate
you
that.
You have full ownership of this place, right?
More or less, I started it all out. Yeah, it's all under my name, definitely. Yeah, I mean, yeah. I'd like to leave the past in the past, if you know, just like work on building from there.
I can't figure out any other way to do that than just probably taking... No. You know what, Tubbo? You know what?
What?
Clean slate. I don't think we should take this down, because at the end of the day... You built it. I think.
I think it also helped show my initiative that I want to bring to the burger shop as well.
Of course. But I have an idea. How about we integrate this land, this structure to Las Nevadas?
What, you want it to become part of Las Nevadas?
Yeah. You know what? We can forget about everything in the past. How about we integrate this beautiful place to Las Nevadas?
Because it's built on part of Las Nevadas.
It's built in proximity.
I mean, it makes sense. It's just on the outskirts, maybe.
Yeah. So we can incorporate it into the Las Nevadas outskirts, and we can. How would you like that idea? Are you?
Yeah,
down with that?
I mean,
Las Nevadas. It's your structure.
Yeah, I'm a little
like
apprehensive, but I don't see. Well, I mean, as long as, like, I still get ownership, it's just you own the land.
Yeah. I'll own the land. It's like rent, but you're not going to be paying rent, obviously.
Yeah.
But I just want to make sure that this can be, like, part of Las Nevadas, just to avoid any confusion. You know, this is Las Nevadas land.
Is
that cool with you?
Yeah, that's cool with me. Just, like, keep it as it is. Don't change anything. Like, keep the pond, keep the farms.
No, 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 no. Yeah. But we, you know, all this, you know, it does have to be part of Las Nevadas land and all that.
Yeah.
You know what? Let's make it official.
You want to make it official?
I have a booking quill.
I wasn't expecting it to move this quickly. Could we sign it from up the top of the needle, and so we can have a look over it while we do it? You reckon?
That is a wonderful idea.
Because I mean, that's where we first had our discussion about it. I mean, it only makes sense. Like, just to cross the T's, dot the I's, end the chapter. If you know what I mean, leave the past in the past.
Yeah, yeah. Especially since it's part of Las Nevadas.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it makes sense to sign it in like probably one of the most significant buildings here, I'd say.
Absolutely. Absolutely, Tubbo. You know, I think it's great that you're taking steps to, you know, move your life forward. I never really spoke to you properly after everything went down in Lemanburg.
Technoblade. Damn.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, we did talk about this whole project, you and me, but you know what? I want to know a little bit about your insight as to what happened with Lemanburg. And all that. What did you do after that? I didn't see you after
Technoblade left. I mean, to be honest, I haven't seen much of Technoblade either. I've seen like barely any of anyone. I've just been kind of isolated on my own, just hanging out. Like I said, I haven't had much of a purpose. Just kind of drifting around, walking around, just living in the past mainly. And I'm really trying to put that behind me. What happened after you? Went AWOL in Lemanburg. Well, I mean, it's all kind of a blur. It all happened so fast. Like, the values of everything just changed away. We lost our core values and then the country fell after that, which is really, that's more or less it.
Yes, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm not paying enough attention.
It's okay. I've been thinking about this.
I don't want to make you feel ignored or anything like that.
It's fine.
We'll insert the coordinates later, but I think really fast we can just sign that and we're good to go.
So property of the cookie butter is now part of Las Nevadas land and under its ruling constitution.
Yeah, we'll insert the coordinates later.
Yeah, I sign on the second page, right?
Yeah. Go ahead and sign it on the second page there.
There you go. That's nothing. Like, I still own the property. Everything there still belongs to me. It's just part of Las Nevadas and it heeds to the laws.
It's just part of Las Nevadas. It's territory. It's under its rules, constitution, all that, which is. But, you know, you integrating to the country, I think that's a first big step. Tubbo.
Yeah.
I just want to say thank you. Your disposition to help out with Las Nevadas and everything. It means a lot. You wanting to manage the place. And again, I felt like that was the right thing for you to do as well, because.
Oh, thank you.
You told me briefly about, you know. How much you miss Lemanburg, how much you miss it.
Yeah, it's been, I'm going to be honest, it's been a little upsetting, as of late, especially. I've just been missing it, especially because it was a year ago yesterday it all started, and I've been there since the beginning of it, and to see where it's come now is really upsetting. But it's really admirable what you've done here. Like, you've really, it's got a solid foundation. You're quite inspiring. I feel very inspired just looking around.
Thank you, Tubbo, thank you. You know, thank you. That means a lot.
No, it's all right, man.
It's been things can get difficult, but I appreciate that, Tubbo. And at the end of the day, you know, whatever you need from me, whatever you require anything at all from me, just let me know, Tubbo. That restaurant, you're managing it now. You have a project to go off on. And you know what? At the end of the day, there's a lot of opportunity. There's a lot of opportunity. So anything else you need, anything else you want to do, just come talk to me and figure stuff out.
Yeah, I guess it's probably about time for me to get back to work. I want to go scope out. Apparently, they had a burger shop, they said. So I want to make sure that, we're taking strides in the right direction for the competition. I'm going to make some burgers that will be remembered.
Right. Would you want me to go with you? You'd rather take that
alone? I think I'll go alone. I think I can see it just over there, actually. Is that their little van there, just behind the like pool area, like the penthouse?
Yeah, I like to call it a market study, you know? Like, you study the market. I usually do that alone as well.
Yeah, so...
Tubbo, I'll be up here.
Yeah, I'll come meet with you after I've done my market study, and we can start to come up with some groundbreaking material for the burger shop.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Actually, you know what? Just whenever you come back, just meet me at the burger shop. I'll be doing some redecoration, stuff like that, make the place look nice. All right.
Oh yeah, sounds that sounds good, amazing. Tubbo. Yeah, thank you so much for the job as well. Yeah, I'll be on my way now.
Tubbo, don't thank me. I should be thanking you. Honestly, you are a great. You're like a gear, you know. You're like a gear in the machine, and you're one of the most important like gears, you know. Like when you take out a gear and the machine stops working, you're like a pillar. You're like a pillar to our structure.
Oh, thank you, man.
Is what I'm saying.
I appreciate that a lot.
Yeah. Okay. I'll talk to you later.
I'll be on my way now. I'll catch you in a bit. Goodbye, mate. Bye.
All right. See ya.
Oh, I thought he was gonna be more upset, honestly, about the. I thought he was going to be more upset, honestly, about the cookie outpost. I'm glad we got that all sorted. That's really, really cool. All right, so I want to go check out this new burger shop. I think it's going to be nice. I think it's going to be really, really nice. Because the way Wilbur was describing it, it must be a really lovely place. I think it's going to be awesome. Look at that. Oh! Rambu's here. Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing all right.
Doing all right. What were you up to?
Well, I was just talking over with Quackity Burger Business, you know.
did everything go well? Is everything okay with that?
Yeah. I assume it's like I'm pretty sure it's
you
fantastic.
Sure?
Yeah. 100%. I think it's going really well. Can I come inside? I want to have a look at all your. I wanted to have a little look at all your place.
Sure. It's not much right now, but we're still me and Wilbur are still working on it.
Why do you trust Wilbur so much?
Hmm.
Why do you trust Wilbur?
Well, okay. Here's the thing. Basically, I don't like. Trust Wilbur yet, but I definitely do have more trust in him than you do. But
yeah.
I mean, 13 years. I mean,
yeah,
13 years. A guy has got to change throughout all of that, right?
Yeah, I suppose so. I mean, I don't not believe that he's changed. I just think that he has to have the opportunity to prove it because trust.
And that's why I'm here is so that. When he does something that does redeem himself, then someone can be there that'll be able to see it and everything. And honestly, I would rather have it be me, the person, rather have the person that be there be me instead of maybe someone else. So,
yeah, I guess that makes a lot of sense, I guess. Yeah. I don't know. I'm not sure I feel prepared to put my life in his hands again, if you know what I mean.
Well, this isn't putting my life in his hands. This is just making a little burger shop and everything. Are you like okay with all of this, right?
Oh yeah. It's fine. It's fine.
Okay.
I think it's quite enjoyable.
That's good. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I understand it all. It makes a lot of sense.
You sure you understand? Because like If you need me to stop, then I'll stop. But...
No, it's all right. It's all right. Is there a reason? Like, I noticed that you hadn't told Wilbur about the tax reasons, marriage.
Yeah. Well, that's just because from what I've heard from Tommy and everything, the Wilbur that 13 years ago, at least, might have he used stuff against Tommy and everything. So, you know, just in case. I mean, I still trust Wilbur, just not. You know, not super fully, but still at least a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, I completely understand that. That makes a lot of sense,
yeah.
Honestly.
So I mean, I like working with him as well. I mean, it's nice to just to do something.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I think the competition will be good. Yeah. I mean, I'm very excited. I mean, I haven't felt this happy in quite a while. It feels like I finally got, you know, something under my belt, something I can. You know, really sink my teeth into and be a part of it. It feels like I'm part of like a bigger cause now. Like,
so you're sure that this is that you're all okay with everything that's going on?
Yeah, of course. It's just friendly competition, man. It's going to be awesome. If anything, okay. It will just be better for consumers. It means we're going to make better things for everyone.
Yeah, that makes sense, at least. I mean,
are you all right?
How did you bury the hatchet with Quackity, though? That's what I don't get.
Bury the hatchet? What do you mean by that?
I mean, how did you make peace with him? Because the last time we spoke about him, you were talking about how he had a role in your unfortunate removal of life.
Yeah, and he did, but I mean, to be honest, it's as much... Well, no, I mean, I'm not even sure it is as much Quackity's fault as Wilbur, but, like, I don't... Like, I mean, I was gonna die no matter what that day. I mean, it just happened. I mean, I don't... Okay. I don't have much quarrel with him. I think it's A-okay. I mean, he seems to have... No, I mean, look at what he's built. Like, he seems good. I mean, yeah, I managed to also, like, clean over all the ruckus that we had about the cookie outpost and stuff as well. So that's in the past.
Wait, he's
now.
Okay with that now?
Yeah. Yeah, he promised me a good life. Like...
What do you mean? Was your life not good before?
No. It was. He talked a lot about Lamanberg. And, like, yeah.
That wasn't really that much of a good life for you, though, was it?
Oh, no. You've only heard the bad bits of Lamanberg. Lamanberg was amazing.
He promised you, like, the good bits.
Yeah, basically, which is, it's awesome.
That's good.
Yeah, so I figured out how to, like, get rid of the tension regarding the cookie outpost. We came to an agreement, signed a contract, dot the T's and the I's, you know, put the past in the past. I'm excited to, you know, keep moving forward. It's exciting.
Okay, awesome. So he's okay with the cookie shop now?
Oh, yeah. He's 100% okay. Basically, we just came to the agreement is... I wasn't acting myself, like, before when I was working on the cookie shop. I wasn't being myself. I was I was just upset and sad, and I was like, I just wanted to have something to feel part of something bigger again. But then I realized instead of fighting the thing that would have given me that feeling, I tried to make my own. I dug my heels in. It wasn't really the right thing to do. So we signed a contract. So the cookie shop's still owned by me, but it just exists within Los Nevados now. And, it follows its laws and regulations.
Okay, so is everything's... Wait, so how exactly, again, sorry, how did you make Quackity okay with it all?
So we went up to the needle, talked it out, we wrote up a contract, and I just basically agreed to have the cookie shop become part of Los Nevados. Because, I mean, it doesn't make sense.
But you gave away the cookie shop?
I mean, I didn't give it away. I still own it. It's just it's now part of Los Nevados.
Which is owned by... You gave away the cookie shop.
Well, yeah, but not entirely.
Yeah, entirely.
No, that's not how it works at all. It's still owned by me. It's just... It exists inside his territory.
Los Nevados, which is owned by Quackity.
No, it's not like that at all.
You gave it... It seems like you just...
No, there's a lot more to it than that. It's not black and white, like I just gave it to him. I still own it. I still have full control over it. It's just... It just follows his laws, which is fine.
And his... Awesome, cool. That's great. Oh, would you look at that? The bread is stale. I gotta go.
Oh,
but it was nice talking to you. I'm gonna go throw this bread in the river.
Okay.
Right. Thanks for stopping on by. I'll talk to you later. All right.
Okay. Bye. I wasn't expecting that to go quite like that. I didn't think that mattered that much. I was not expecting it to, He didn't seem... Oh, God. That felt a little awkward. It's mine to give away. I mean, I built the entire place. Like, I built all of it. That is so weird. Okay, I'm going to come up with some good burger recipes now. I didn't actually manage to... I probably should have done some more research actually looking at all of them. That would have been nice.
Ah, fuck.
Oh, God. Hello.
Holy shit. You...
Sorry. I didn't... I fucking... Honestly, I just didn't
Tubbo,
notice you
Tubbo,
just then.
You were
I didn't...
supposed to be here. Work has already started. You
work has already started. Oh, sorry. Jesus.
You're a little late.
This is a new schedule for me. I'm
Remember,
sorry.
Remember, we can't build a Kingdom Hero fast food burger. I'm sorry. I've got like 10 things in my mind right now. Tubbo, yeah. You cannot keep arriving late, okay?
Okay.
We gotta make sure this place runs very well. Listen.
Yeah?
Check this out. I have an idea.
What's up?
Here, help me take this thing down.
Okay.
I have a great idea. You're gonna love this, all right? You're gonna love this, Tubbo.
Yeah, well, wait.
Right?
Yeah?
When Wilbur sees this, because I know he's gonna be fucking, like, spying around, when Wilbur sees this shit, he's gonna freak out. He's gonna finally realize
Why do you care so much about
idiot.
He's what Wilbur's
an idiot
doing.
For doing whatever it is he decided to do. Okay, check this
okay.
out. How many blocks is this? This is... Okay, check this out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh my
okay.
God, what is this?
Check this out. You're gonna love this. And
yeah, yeah. I'm excited for it.
That fucking guy really thinks he can, like, come into the restaurant and blow the goddamn place up. I'm just like, what,
I thought you weren't that bothered.
What does he think he is? What the fuck does he think he is? It's so fucking annoying how he does this shit, and he thinks, whatever, man. Check this out. Once they see this, they're gonna realize that they are no competition for us. They are no fucking competition.
You got like what an ad?
Check this out. You ready, Tubbo? You
yeah.
ready?
Yeah. What's that?
What
oh my God!
What do you think? What do you think?
That's awesome, dude! What the hell?
I just made it. I can't wait to see.
Oh my God!
On his like the fucking the whatever his stupid fucking face is gonna look like, right?
That is awesome.
I'm gonna absolutely. Wilbur's gonna see this. He's gonna realize he messed with the wrong fucking person, Tubbo. He's gonna realize that I am no one to mess around with. That everything he fucking did with his little buddy Rambo is... I'm sorry, I don't know if you guys are friends. I don't speak ill of anyone, but for fuck's sake. They fucked up. They fucked with the wrong person. He is going to regret what he did to me.
What did they do?
My fucking country.
I feel like I've been left out. You hired me. What happened?
I'm sorry. No. Just ignore me. I'm just rambling. Tubbo, you know what we gotta do? You know what we have to do. All right. We, apart from burgers, we gotta sell like more shit. We gotta do this like NFT. Have you heard of this NFT thing?
NFT?
We gotta make the Tuburgers NFT.
The Tuburgers NFT.
Tuburgers NFT. Listen, they have an NFT system. We're gonna make an NFT system of your shit, all right?
Okay,
we're gonna
okay.
make it out, for you.
Why not two? Right? What? Just double down. We have two NFTs.
Yes. Okay. I need you to. I do this for me, all right?
Okay.
You need to try Wilbur's burger. You need to try his burger.
Is this Wilbur's burger?
Try it out. Yes, it's his burger.
Okay, Wilbur.
Smelly,
I gotta.
It's so funny.
I've gotta run around a bit. Wait. Okay. Stick with me.
Tubbo. You see this fish tank?
Yeah.
This fish tank looks normal to you.
Yeah.
And it looks normal to them. Okay.
Yeah.
But these fuckers. They left a huge crater in my goddamn restaurant.
Did they?
A huge crater in my fucking premise, and they thought they could get away with it. So I built a fish tank. But this fish tank means much more than that.
Does it?
It means much more than that. This fish tank means that Wilbur is not who he thinks he is, all right? He used to be, like, slick. He used to be, like, all this powerful guy in Lamanberg. He's not the same person anymore.
Why, you think he's changed? Do you think he's his old age, I guess?
Changed, Tubbo? You think Wilbur has changed? Come on. Wilbur hasn't changed one bit. And I'm excited. I'm excited because once he realizes everything that we're doing, everything that we're up to, it's not going to be the fucking same. It's not, Tubbo. I'm going to fucking destroy him. We're going to destroy him, Tubbo. We're going to just...
In the business world. Friendly competition, of course. Like,
yes.
Like, we're not actually going to fucking hurt them. Like,
No.
Financially, maybe, but like...
Sorry, I get a little startled. I'm sorry. I just like competition. I really like it.
Competition's good for everyone. It's like friendly.
Yeah.
The only people that win here is the customer, and that's all that matters. That should be our motto. The customer is all that matters.
I love it. I love it. Let's do that. Yes. Yes. Let's do that. Let's do that, Tubbo. Listen, I, apart from this, sorry, I got a little startled up.
Yeah,
but apart
yeah.
from all this, I think it's important to recognize that we do need competition at the end of the
day. Yeah, 100%. And like, we can't Tubbo, exist without them.
This is your place. This is your place now.
Yeah.
It's right here.
This is very cool.
It's set in stone.
That's, that honestly, is such a cool sign.
You're the manager, honestly. What's next?
So,
what's next,
do you want to hear my three step program? I've got a three step
okay,
program
yeah,
for this one.
To. I would love
meet
to.
Meet me in the kitchen. Whoa. Okay. All so, right,
yes.
So, I thought a couple of ways that we can optimize, like, we can make burgers quick but not sacrifice the flavor. So, from what I can see in their place, they don't have these smokers. These things cook food twice as fast, but you still get the same quality.
Really?
Yeah, so we can sell like smoked steak burgers, is what I'm thinking. Like, we got the Wagyu burgers, if you know what I mean.
No, wait, actually, like Wagyu burgers?
I'm thinking we're doing Wagyu burgers. Like,
I love that. I love that.
Have you ever had a Wagyu burger?
Tubbo, listen, based on what you told me, this project means a lot to you. And that's why I made that sign over there.
Oh, thank you.
Resources, man. Items, wheat farms. What do you need? You say this is an important project to you.
It really
what
is.
Do you need to make this
I mean,
thrive?
The main things we need, we need, like, grain. We need a lot of grain. Like, we're lacking in...
Grain? Okay.
Yeah, we don't have any way to make, like, fresh dough. Look, this is... our supplies are a little dire.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, Jesus. Okay.
You don't want to just close that chest.
Okay. Okay. This is like my first actual day other than the introduction, which was awesome.
Yeah. Of course.
So yeah. So these Tubbo, conventional listen. Ovens, I say we use these for bread and bread only, and we cook all of our steaks in the smokers to give it that authentic, burger taste.
All right. Sounds good. I love it. Tubbo, listen, I'm telling you, whatever you need, big farms built. We'll get big farms built.
Yeah,
you need
okay.
resources, grain, whatever you need. We'll get the best of the best quality products.
All right. And when? Hey, how soon do you reckon you can get the grain farm done? We want it to be, like, you know, all natural.
Is grain different to wheat?
Well, no. They're the same, man. It's just, you know, we take the grain from the wheat, grind it into flour to make the bread.
Tubbo, come with me.
Yeah? Where are we going?
Yeah, check this
oh
out.
Oh my
Tubbo.
God.
Check it out. Yeah, I thought you'd seen it. No, look
no,
at this.
No, I must have completely overlooked this.
And
oh,
we also
wow.
have a spot for the meat. You know, the only the highest quality meat. They are
oh my
being
God.
Grass-fed. They're be these cows are being grass-fed, Tubbo.
Oh, they don't have too much space.
Tubbo, listen. I want to emphasize this. This is all you.
This is your
project, all right?
Yeah.
The sign out there says to burger. And as far as I'm aware, you manage the restaurant. So whatever you need. Listen, also, I know there are some food regulations that are always put down.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
we need
you need any way around the
Constitution. Because I noticed the kitchen's like looking a little worse for wear. We're going to need to get that cleaned up. Otherwise, we might have
health violation. We'll get it cleaned up. We'll get it cleaned up for you. We'll
like, it's
sure
really
it
gunky.
Nice.
Like, it's genuinely, it's really strange.
I had a friend that lived there for a while.
In the kitchen?
He left a little bit of... Yeah, it's a long story. It was a friend who's just kind of like... Yeah, he left the place a little slimy. All right, he left the place
Ew.
A little slimy. I'll get
Dude,
it cleaned
how?
Up. I'll get it cleaned
what?
Up. Yeah. He actually.
When was the last time he's showered, bro? Oh.
Oh man. Oh, you're in for it. You know what? You should meet him one day. You should definitely meet him one day.
Does he still live there, or does he got his own place now?
He's around. I think I haven't seen him in a bit, but he can. I haven't seen him a bit, Tubbo. That's actually
you
a
haven't
word.
Seen him? Oh.
He should.
I mean, if you need anyone to like point. Lead a search, if it gets to that point, I can do that.
No. Don't worry.
No, it's not like a you know. Big deal. No? Okay.
Focus on your project. I don't want you to stray away.
I say,
from
do you want to start to come up with some like some names for some burgers? Do you have any
Let's
signs
do it.
Or anything?
Let's do it. I mean, original classic Tubbo, that's a burger. Come on.
Yeah. Oh,
right?
Definitely.
Yes, yes.
We need to put the menu classic. Up here. So this is
yeah,
like
yeah, yeah, yeah.
we should number them so it's easier for people to order.
Okay, okay. Let's
hear
it. Let's
actually, I'm going to be honest, I've got no idea how to spell Taburger. Is that right?
Taburger. Perfect. That's perfect.
And
yes.
I'm thinking at this end is where we put our high quality stuff. I'm talking like gold. Like, come on. I've seen how extravagant this city is. Like,
so you're not really looking for fast food. You're looking to make like a proper
burger place.
Well,
no. What I'm thinking
is
we do both. Like, we can account for the masses. Like, the people who want that fine dining. And then the people who just want a quick bite.
That is genius.
And do you want to know what the second step in my three-step program is?
Yes, yes, of course.
We need a drive-through on this place. We need drive-through Wagyu beef.
Oh, wrong wall. People stay here. Yeah,
that would... You don't want to lower the property.
All right, I try to act impulsively.
No, it's okay. It makes
sense. Really badass, but
So, you reckon we could get like a road going through here for the drive-thru? Do you reckon that would work?
100%. 100%.
Because I reckon that could drive our sales through the roof. Because, but look, they've got a burger van. They go on the roads. We're with the roads, if you know what I mean.
100%, Tubbo. 100%. You're coming up with all these like great ideas. I couldn't have chosen a better person to run this place than you, Tubbo.
Oh, thank you.
I think that's one of your
I'm gonna be honest, I'm really enjoying just having a place to feel like I'm doing stuff again.
Yeah.
Wait, so how many numbers we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
We got a few. I don't know if anyone has told you this, Tubbo, but one of your most underrated features is your creativity and your drive do good things.
Oh, God.
I don't think I've ever seen you, Tubbo, and have said, this is a bad person or this is...
One of the fish just may have offed itself.
One of the most underrated features, Tubbo, and I don't think anyone has really told you this, is your drive to do good things. I don't think I've ever seen you and I've told myself this is a bad person. I feel like you're just very inherently good.
Oh, thank you so much, mate.
Yes, Tubbo. So, listen, build up the menu.
I will. Get on it.
Get it working. I'll 100%. Make sure to start up the wheat farm. Make sure that everything works for you.
Yeah, so... Oh, what the hell? Have you seen what's in this book? Sorry, I mean...
That motherfucker.
What the fuck is this, dude?
That guy's...
Who's done this?
That guy thinks he's so fucking funny. Yo, Big Q, something is wrong with your doors. You should probably check that out. I think you've got... Shut the fuck up.
Whoa.
Fuck you, dude. How do I get fucking rid of this thing? Fucking get it out of my sight.
Okay. Holy.
I'll spit on the book and fucking throw it in the garbage can. What the hell is wrong with that guy?
Who wrote that? How do you know who wrote that?
Who do you think? Who do you think wrote it, all right? Who do you think wrote it, Tubbo? Yeah, of course it was fucking Wilbur. Do you know what he did at this place? He fucking came in here and blew... Oh, my God.
Yeah, I heard about the explosion. I never got to see it, though.
It doesn't matter. And you know what, Tubbo? Don't even, like, bring it up in front of him. Don't even, like, bring it up at all.
Okay.
Don't talk about it.
What,
that
so
never happened,
we
okay?
Just, we just... You know, we're big. We're better than that. You know, we just...
We're bigger and better and everything good.
We don't need to resort to sabotage.
100%. 100%. I don't... Whatever, man. Listen, Tubbo, I'm going to go back to my office.
Okay.
I'm going to count how much money I have, which is a lot.
Okay.
And
that sounds like a good idea.
I'm going to come down here for a quick lunch break. And then I'm going to tell everyone to start helping with your wheat farm and your grain farm and your bread farm. And we're going to up the production of cow meat.
I'm going to knuckle down and get some new recipes done. Thank you so much. I'm going to get off and start working on that.
This is all you, Tubbo.
Thank you, man. This is unbelievable. I can't thank you enough, honestly.
I can't thank you enough, Tubbo. I really can't. I'll go back to my office, get some
work
done.
I'll get to the kitchen.
Now, how much money we have, and...
Yeah, goodbye, mate. See you later.
Not gonna lie, Tubbo. fish was just it's done some bad shit to my stomach. I really have to go.
Oh god, I'm so sorry.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I will get the fish water treated. Bye, mate. Goodbye.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. Oh, okay. Right, let's crack on to work. I'm gonna head off and start working on some new recipes. It's gonna be exciting. I'm so excited to have this new job finally.